I think it's very important that Israel calibrates its use of force and minimizes the use of live fire. Lethal force should be used only as a last resort under imminent threat of death or serious injury. And also it's important that Hamas and the leaders of demonstrations keep the protesters away from the fence and prevent all violent actions and provocations or attempts to breach the fence that obviously make the situation also even more serious.
اليوم وبغصة مؤلمة في القلب يوضع قطاع غزة الحبيب مزيدا من أبنائنا وشبابنا. وأطفالنا الذين خرجوا بشكل سلبي احتجاجا على الحياة البائسة التي يعيشونها والتي يفرضها الاحتلال الإسرائيلي ظلما وعدوانا عليهم. خرجوا ليعبروا عن رفضهم للذل والقهر والاستعباد وليطالبوا بحقوقهم المشروعة بما فيها حق تقرير المصير وحق العودة.
The cycle of death works like this. First, they incite people to violence. Then they place as many civilians as possible, including women and children, in the line of fire to maximize civilian casualties. Then they blame Israel, and then they come here to complain to the UN. This is the deadly game the Palestinians play, and they play it at the expense of innocent children.
Israel has a right to defend its borders. But it has to defend them according to international law and principles. So I think we've been very clear. The use of lethal force must only be a last resort. And you just have to look at the different casualty figures on both sides to see that it's not being used as a last resort.